And after wrapping up in Hawaii, Mr. Obama will head down under for his first Australian visit since becoming US president.
For all the details, we're joined in Canberra by our political reporter Amanda Hart. Amanda, what's on the US president's agenda?
Tash, you can certainly tell someone very important is coming to town. This morning we saw army choppers circling the city in preparation for Barack Obama's arrival. Now, he does have a very busy two-day schedule. He's due to touch down at 3:25 on Wednesday afternoon here in Canberra, where he'll have an opening ceremony. From there, he'll be whisked off to Parliament House, where he will have a meeting with Julia Gillard. Then there'll be a joint press conference. Later that evening, he'll attend a state dinner at Parliament House. Thursday is going to be an extremely busy day as well. In the morning, he'll lay a wreath at the Australian War Memorial, have a meeting with the opposition leader Tony Abbott and address Parliament. He'll also visit a local primary school before getting back on the plane and heading to Darwin. Now there, the president will lay a wreath at the USS Peary Memorial, then address US and Australian troops. Then he's back on the plane again, heading to Bali for the East Asian Summit. Now, although it is only a two-day trip, and for most of us, a two-day trip wouldn't be too much of a hassle, but as Dan Sutton reports, no trip with the United States president is hassle-free.
He has two helicopters, two limousines, and on overseas trips, even two Air Force Ones. When America's commander-in-chief travels, you'd be forgiven for thinking you're seeing double.
It's an absolutely enormous task to get a president moving.
From the outside, the presidential plane and the decoy look like 747s, but that's where the similarities end. They have in-flight refueling, a virtual Oval Office with secure phone lines, and high-tech defences against missiles and cyber attackers.
As far as we know, there is no such escape, pod, but it has practically everything else, including a room that can be turned into an operating room.
As a White House correspondent, Bill Plant has witnessed 30 years of motorcades, all designed to protect the presidential limo.
They call it the Beast because it is an enormous piece of machinery.
Bulletproof is just the start. The doors have 20-centimetre thick armour plating with compartments for shotguns. At the front, there's a night vision camera and tear gas cannon. The cabin is completely sealed, blocking air and noise. In the boot, there's oxygen canisters and reportedly vials of the president's blood. The motorcade is often 17 cars long.
A large vehicle, which is security, men with guns inside, you know. And then a couple of limousines. You're never sure which one the president is in. That's for security reasons as well.
And when the motorcade comes to town, expect delays. Travel routes and timings are not made public. Every other motorist will face red lights while Barack Obama gets a corridor of green. In the United States, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.